So today we are going to discuss one of the technique of spectroscopy. It is a technique of spectroscopy. It is a part of spectroscopy that is of emission type, flame photometry. Flame photometry, more accurately or very precisely, it is known as the flame atomic emission spectroscopy. It is a type of emission spectrophotometry. It is a branch of emission spectrophotometry where the molecules are in the form of atoms. Again, all the spectrophotometric techniques and the theory involved behind each spectroscopy, these are very similar. The molecules, the atoms are involved in absorption as well as the emission type of spectroscopy. So in flame photometry, a photoelectric flame photometer is an instrument. It is used for the analysis of organic as well as inorganic substances. Again, for both qualitative as well as quantitative analysis, particularly the metals, metal ions, sodium, potassium, lithium, calcium, etc. So this flame photometry estimation is, or the measurement is, based on the intensity of emitted light. In flame photometry, it is based on the measurement of intensity of the light emitted when a metal is introduced into the flame. That's why it is known as the flame photometry. A sample is introduced into the flame where the burning of the sample takes place, and the emitted intensity of the radiations are measured. So the wavelength of the color, it gives the information about the what type of the element is present. That is nothing but the qualitative analysis. That is for qualitative analysis. Whereas the second one, that the color intensity. Color intensity gives an idea about the concentration of the element present. That is nothing but the quantitative analysis. So remember, flame photometer, it is an instrument which measures the intensity of light which is emitted when the metal is introduced into the flame. So as soon as the sample is introduced into the flame, the burning phenomenon takes place, and the metal ions emits some characteristic radiations. So the characteristic radiations, these are colored one. This color tells about the nature of the element for their qualitative analysis. And the color intensity tells us how much of the element present, that is for quantitative analysis. So flame photometry is one of the most important spectrophotometry useful for qualitative and quantitative analysis of many inorganic samples. What is the basic principle involved? The principle involved behind the flame photometry, which is a atomic spectroscopy, it works on the base of the fact that the matter absorbs the light at the same wavelength at which it emits the light. Already we have discussed how much the energies get absorbed by the substance, by the molecule. That energy difference, delta E, is directly proportional to the light absorbed by the sample. So atoms of elements. So what is the principle? When the atoms of the elements, when the sample is placed, is subjected to hot flame, specific quantum of thermal energy absorbed by the orbital electrons, and then it becomes unstable at high energy levels, and then it releases the energy as photons of particular wavelength and change back to the ground state, or comes to the ground state. So again, a very basic and simple theory, as we discuss in the spectrophotometry of ultraviolet UV spectroscopy. The atoms of the elements subjected to hot flame for the heating, then specific quantum of thermal energy is get absorbed by the electrons, then it becomes unstable, that it goes to higher excited state and it releases the photons of particular wavelength energy while returning to the ground state. So when a metal salt solution is burned, the metal provides a color ray. Again, the sodium, potassium, lithium, calcium, these are the metal salts. If you prepare the solution of metal salt and if you subject it for the burning on a flame, these metals provides a colored flame. Remember, these metal ions provides a colored flame and each metal ion gives a different colored flame. That's why these are characteristics. Their color flame, change in the color of the flame as soon as it will start the burning. Different metal ions gives a different colored flame. So flame test therefore can be used to test for the absence or presence of the metal ions. Flame test, the color of the flame, their intensity, radiations can be used to test, to check for the absence or presence of the metal ions. So very simple theory and the principle involved behind the flame photometry. Again, we are going to discuss in deep again, in a precise manner, basic one. Now see here, ground state to excited state, from returning from excited state to the ground state, it emits the light radiations as a photon. So liquid samples containing the metal salts, say for example sodium chloride, potassium chloride, these metal salts solution is introduced into a flame. Then solvent is first vaporized, leaving particles of solid salt, which is then vaporized and converts into the gaseous state. If the liquid sample converts to gaseous state, then gaseous state molecules get dissociate to give neutral atoms. A dissociation of the molecules in the gaseous state takes place to neutral atoms, which can be excited by thermal energy of the flame. Gaseous molecules dissociates to give neutral atoms, which can be excited by thermal energy of the flame. Then unstable excited atoms, the unstable excited atoms emits photons from returning to excited to ground state. The measurement of emitted photons forms the basis of the flame photometry. So that is the basic principle, that the measurement of the emitted photons form the basis of the flame photometry. So under the constant and control conditions, that is the flame should be constant one, the pressure should be constant one. So under constant and control conditions, the light intensity of the characteristics wavelength produced by each of the atom, light intensity produced by the substance, produced by the solution of the metal ions, is directly proportional to the number of atoms that are emitting the energy. Obviously, it depends upon the concentration. As the concentration will increase, obviously the emitting energy will also increase. So which in turn directly proportional to the concentration of the substance of the interest in the sample. So various metals emits a characteristic color of light where it is heated. So this is the main principle involved, main theory involved. Various metals emits a characteristic color of light when it is heated, when the sample is subjected for the burning, when sample is introduced on a flame. So now see this table. various elements versus their emission wavelength and their flame color. So sodium emission wavelength 589, and it shows the color yellow. So yellow color flame is obtained if we burn sodium chloride sample on a flame, and the wavelength of that emission light is 589 nanometer. So in the same way, potassium emits the light of wavelength 766 nanometer, and the color appears of the flame is violet in color. In the same way, barium 554 lime green color, calcium 662 orange color, and the lithium emits the light of wavelength 670 nanometer, and the color of the flame then appears as a red color. So very, very important. This theory is very, very important to understand the principle and theory of flame photometer.